Imagine you're looking for an upgrade or you're planning to buy a new bike, but you want something more powerful than your everyday 200cc's and you decide to go on your interstate rides or do those insanely fast highway runs. So the ideal choice is your sport tourer segment. So we have the Ninja 300, Ninja 400 if you have the deep pockets, or maybe look for an R3 in the used market. But looking at the condition of our Indian roads, we have a lot of potholes and insanely huge speed breakups. So when you look at them, the next consideration would be the adventure tourer segment. And today we have this, the Royal Enfield Himalayan. So prior to the Himalayan's launch way back in 2016, we did not have much options when it came to the adventure tourer segment other than the humble 150cc Hero Impulse. But Royal Enfield went out of their comfort zone and gave us the Himalayan 400. Yes, it did have its own share of issues and sometimes quite severe ones. But over the years, they have looked into it and also have improved the bike considerably. This time, we get a fuel-injected motor along with dual-channel ABS and the BS6 one. This one in fact gets the option to switch it off in the rear. So when you hit the trails or go off-road, you get more of that slide action. The Himalayan's engine is more or less same on paper. It still has the same 411cc single cylinder motor, which packs around 24 bhp and 32 Nm of torque. The real change in the engine is felt when you start riding it. The BS4 Himalayan used to feel sluggish and out of breath when it came to acceleration. But with this, the BS6 motor, Royal Enfield have totally revamped the power delivery. Don't get me wrong though, it isn't lightning quick like the Adventure 390, but it surely feels more torquey and happy to give you the power when you need it. But how does it fare against what seems to be the go-to do-it-all bike for India, the Adventure 390? Let's find out. You're willing to shed 1 more lakh rupee compared to the Himalayan's price, and you get a more composed motorcycle. You get more power and more torque compared to the Himalayan's 22 bhp. You get 42 bhp on this one, and you also get more torque. You get 37 Nm of torque. And since we know KTMs are a hoot to drive on your weekend canyon runs and occasional highway speed runs, the same thing can be said for the Adventure 390. The Adventure 390 is a much more versatile motorcycle overall. It can do a variety of things with utmost decency. But once you ride it in different types of terrains, you start understanding how confused this bike is. The suspension and the seat are way too stiff for any sort of good off-road comfort. Yes, the Adventure 390 might be more advanced compared to the Himalayan with traction control, bidirectional quick shifter and switchable ABS. It still doesn't feel as well planted and confidence inspiring as the Himalayan on off-road. Although, once you take these both bikes on the highway, it's a complete different story. The Adventure 390 is much more powerful over here and you can really see how much of a difference 20 horsepower makes. The Adventure 390 shoots off into the distance when it comes to acceleration and top speed compared to the Himalayan, which struggles to go above 120 kmph even with its new and improved engine. So the BS6 Himalayan, you get an option to switch off your rear ABS, which is very good when you come to trails out here. And the instrument cluster is almost the same thing. You get a tachometer and a digital speedometer, and you get a compass. That's the only thing you get. Compared to the ADV390, you get a completely digital console and you can manage your ABS, KTM MyRide, Bluetooth, GPS navigation, and also you can manage your traction control and ABS from here itself. So both of them have the option to go all the way off, and that's what makes it fun. But compared to the Himalayan, the KTM has a stiffer suspension. I would say it's rather road focused to a complete hardcore setup. Like the international models, they get the adjustable suspensions for compression and rebound. They should have gotten it here in India. Other than that, on the road, it's just like a KTM. It's fun to go into the corners. Your weekend kart rides are going to be amazing. But on the trails, yes, it's fun around here in this soft off-road. But when you go for heavy hardcore off-roading, that will help you out a lot. So the Royal Enfield Himalayan sits lower compared to the Adventure 390 at 800 mm. So someone who's, well, the average height 5 feet 6, Himalayan is a more comfortable bike. Also, it has a more comfortable seat. So if you're going solo or going with a pillion, that's a good bike. And the Adventure is more like just a standard Duke 390, but with an off-road kit on. So it gets stiffer suspensions compared to the Himalayan, so it can manage the off-road quite well. But if you go hardcore, Himalayan is the pick for you. The suspension is more forgiving, and it does not have any electronics. The single channel ABS, which you can switch it on and off, so that is quite forgiving for you when you come here in off-road. Adventure 390, given at the hands of a guy who knows how to ride a bike, it's a hoon machine. So you take those weekend canyon runs, instead of riding a naked bike, ride this. And you want to go off-road, you have a bad patch of road, you can just pick this up. Same thing can be said for this. This glides over all the potholes and speed breakers that you throw at it. So the needs are different. This is more punch in the gut power. This is more relaxed. This likes to hoon around. This just likes to chill at 90-100 kmph all day long. So they both need work, but like we said, the international model comes with an adjustable suspension. Wish we had got that here. So which one I would choose? I would choose the ADV 390 because, well, it's just a Duke 390 which is more versatile. So occasional bad patches, you don't have to worry about it. It glides over it quite well. The suspension is a little bit on a stiffer side, but that helps when you're going on your highway runs and your canyon runs. On off-road, it's quite decent. But this one, it's more soft and just glides over anything you throw at it. So if it's only for your 200 kilometers runs, you know, occasional soft roading and highway trails and etc., this is the bike. But if you're going to do all that and also tour along, and you don't want the punch in the gut power, you want a relaxed engine, so that's the pick for you. I would choose this one because it's more fun to ride. Let me know your pick in the comments down below. Do follow us on our Instagram and check out our website. I'm Kiran and I'm signing out. I'll see you soon.